very enthusiastic and I want to explore.
That's picking up on that. So tell me about your spiritual experiences just before you get into this space.
Okay, I have almost died 3 times. I was in 2 comas. I regularly, not regularly, like once a year, will see my dad in my dream. We'll talk about life, what's going on in the world. I have a guardian angel, as instructed me by a spirit medium a year ago.
Do you know their name?
Yeah, it's Yoksan Cruz. Yoksan Cruz, Y-O-Q-S-A-N, a local here, growing up here. He died in a car crash in 2014. And ever since then, I've had this string of bad luck and protection. So,
do you have anxiety around that?
I have a little anxiety over the fact that I didn't really resolve the issues with him because he was going down a dark path and I didn't want to be with him on that. And he died by himself. But I've learned to forgive him for the things that he did and move on. I can hope for the best for him. He left a legacy here and I just hope his legacy lives on.
So as you're verbalizing this, there's some stuff coming up in the gut that is rooted around anxiety. It's also something, a deep pain is coming up on the left side, which is like boom. The other side. Just to talk a little bit about the work that I do, is I work with the physical and energetic body. I become a direct channel for your guides to move through. Basically, when my chakras, my energy points are open and clear, I'm a receptor of your ancestors, like your spirit team. And when our spirit teams meet, then that's when the magic happens. And you said you've never worked with any kind of rape.
No.
Okay, so it's pronounced rape or hape.
Hape.
There's two names.
Okay.
And it's a shamanic stuff. And this medicine comes from a very good friend that I highly trust. When working with a medicine, you always want to have a deep respect for it.
Of course.
And always use it with intention. So this is sourced from Peru, from the Amazon. And I brought out 5 different types. So each one is a little bit of a different sensation. I want you to intuitively choose the one that calls to you, because in the end, this is really about you being your own intuitive guide and feeling into what calls to you. Because a lot of times as, you know, as patients or clients, we tend to rely on the person that's holding space for us.
Yes.
And that's the opposite of how I work. I want you to be within your strength. I want you to use your magic, your light, to tune better into yourself.
I will do it the way I always do it.
Okay. So, Chakruna. This one is super earthy. It works with, all the medicines work with the pineal gland. A lot of times we take in different things into the body, like fluoride, meat, different things from our environment that calcify the pineal gland. So each one opens up the pineal gland as well as the other chakras.
Yes.
And this also works with the mucus.
Yeah.
So it stays in the sinuses. So you're going to experience a little blast to the pineal gland.
Yeah.
And you can feel some tingling sensations in your head. You can feel extreme levels of pain.
Yeah.
And I just want you to breathe through it. Okay? Just try to be as present as possible. If you feel like you want to have a loogie, do it. Okay. Don't swallow it because you don't want that energy to
go back in.
Exactly. And try not to blow your nose for as long as you can.
Okay. I never do anyway, so it's good.
Try to hold it in for as long as you can. And let the medicine just work for you.
Okay.
And breathe deeply. If you feel like something is getting stuck, take a deeper breath and think about letting go and releasing. So the tools that we have here are, this is called a tepe.
Yes.
And this is like full throttle tepe.
Yeah.
Okay,
yeah.
So it's like both at once. Mm-hmm. This one is one side at a time. So yeah. You choose the one that
helps. That one. This one's well, locked. So it'll just come back out.
So what's going on here?
I've always had that. Just party aftermath of, you know, that. So after a while, it can both work, actually.
Do you want to blow your nose first?
Yeah. It sometimes it's blocked. That's just normal.
Get it all out.
Yeah, I'm both of it.
Okay, and so if you feel like I have energy that's not moving, that's stuck, we can do another round.
Yeah.
And also, if another medicine calls to you,
yeah.
You can do another variety. So basically, what's going to happen is, so that you don't blow it back into my mouth.
Yeah, I don't want that.
You're going to take two breaths in through your mouth, out of your mouth. Exhale. On the second one, you're gonna hold. Okay? I'm gonna blow with force. We're gonna start with your left side, okay? And then we're gonna shift into your right side when you feel ready. Okay? And after I blow it last through your pineal gland, you're gonna take a deep breath through your mouth. Okay, keep breathing. You're gonna feel a little shocking sensation, so just breathe through it. And then when you feel like it starts to ease up, then you can breathe through. So we're just going to open up the space first. Okay? So let's just relax, sit up nice and tall, close your eyes, and then just ease your mind through the breath, breathing mental clarity into your space. Take a deep sigh, exhale, make some noise, let it go, whatever you're holding on to, drop it to the earth. Take another inhale through your nose, just kind of scanning through your physical body, checking in for any tension, something that you're holding. Another deep sigh, exhale it out, dropping into the earth, inviting all our guides to be present. The energy of the earth is here to support us. The ascended masters, gods, goddesses, deities that are linked to your highest self. Inviting the essence of this medicine into our space. Asking for kind, clear, and gentle messages to move through us today. And allowing us to have the most benevolent outcome for today's session that's aligned for our highest good. just a little bit. Two big breaths in and out of your mouth. And bring the second one in and hold.
There's a pulsing thing, yes, you are right.
Tell me what you're saying.
Feel like right here, right there, it's slowly sleeping on my left side. It doesn't hurt. And it's like if you're touching oil, you feel the texture is there. I feel like my whole thing is like pulling up. Body, but not in a bad way. I can breathe. Taste it in my mouth.
Remember, don't swallow it. No. You just spit it out.
But I feel fine.
Sometimes one side can feel more intense than the other.
Of course. Oh, of course.
ask your highest self if you would like to receive another round, another clearing, and if you're supposed to work with the same medicine or something different.
No, not in a bad way, like...
What's wrong with your heart?
No, like, something in my heart that is just, like, I feel...
A little stuck?
Yeah. And so, I ask myself,
I've been feeling this for you for days,
yeah.
And I was like, is this mine? I'm getting a note, it's not mine. And there's something locked up that feels like it's underneath the heart and the rib cage.
Yeah.
Do you have any, like, physical injuries or anything that, like, the past that bothers you?
I got a hip problem. I think I had a rib that healed itself.
Okay, that's the rib.
Yeah.
That's the rib. Yeah. You can blow now.
Yeah.
Get it all out, and then we'll do the yes. So that one's Queen of the Forest. It's a little bit more intense.
Yeah.
That one's super earthy, and it feels a little bit more relaxed. The Queen of the Forest will kind of take you, lift you up, and then bring you back down.
Yeah, I felt that. I felt the burning, and I felt the oneness in me just being. It's rare that I can just quiet my mind. It was nice.
So it's basically like, the best way to describe it is thinking about your windshield, like, fogged over on the car, and then taking a fluid that's in your car, and letting the windshield go like this. So it basically, like, clears the fog out, so your vision's gonna be more clear, you're gonna feel more grounded or relaxed in the mind. We finish this sentence.
Of course. Just comforting someone when they're sad, putting a hand on someone's shoulder when they're just, like, angered.
You use your right hand?
Yes. I touch animals with my right hand, and I comfort plants with my right hand. Yeah. I use my whole basis of life.
Your magic hands?
Yes, my magic hand, exactly. I hold my camera on my right hand, so everything's on my right hand. My left hand is rarely used.
Obviously, the masculine, the right side is about, like, moving, production, getting things done, and the left side is about nurturing and mothering yourself and dropping oranges because of yin.
Yeah.
And do you feel like you're more in the masculine?
Yeah, I'm more in the moving. I don't have time for myself to.
Well, you don't take time for yourself.
I don't take time for myself for the zen. I don't, and it's sad, but I don't. I'm always moving and always.
What does that feel or look like for you?
Not taking the time to find my center, but taking the time to acknowledge it. Not worrying about what I gotta do in 2 hours, what I gotta do the next day. Like, just sitting somewhere and just breathing and not worrying. And that's always been on my mind ever since I started everything. I'm always worried, for the next day, and it never stops.
Do you feel like you're living in living towards the future more?
I'm working towards the future. I'm living in the present, but working towards the future. I'm always looking at things and looking at the sky and sitting down and watching butterflies go around. I love it. I love nature. But in terms of planning, no, I'm always doing the future. I'm always doing what I gotta do next month. And I don't really think about the now.
Okay, so I think it's really challenging for most people to live in the present moment.
Yeah.
Because we're either stuck in the past, letting those things affect our daily, or we're thinking about what's going to happen with our lives.
Yeah. That's a challenge.
So, second one, there is a possibility of vomiting.
Yeah.
So, embrace it.
Okay.
If you get a vomit, if you use a bathroom, that's natural. Yeah. You're getting an internal energetic flush.
Yes.
So just listen to the emotions of you and don't fight it.
Yeah. Okay. It's rare that I throw up, but let's find out.
Do you eat anything?
I used to only eat, like, I had like a handful of peanuts.
Feeling the same
effect? Yes. Okay. No, actually, this one.
Do you want to use this one or this one?
That one. It's just
full throttle.
Yeah, full throttle.
Okay. So if you feel like you need to lay down, lay down, feel busy, just rest.
Right.
I've had people in sessions where they receive the medicine and they're just like laid out for 2 hours. So just do you. I'm here to hold space.
Okay.
And you got some stuff that's like stuck down in here.
Yeah, I feel good.
Yeah, what's going on here?
Back pain and stress. But just normal everyday stress, really. I've had that for a while now. Like, yeah, normal everyday stress.
What's going on here?
Worried about my girlfriend and worrying about the condo that I was supposed to clean today. That's it.
What's the worry about the girlfriend?
Nah, because she's doing it by herself the first time, and I'm just worried that if my name's made out there, so if she fucks up, I get the blame for it.
Do you trust her?
We just had the same conversation today. I'm giving her the benefit of the doubt that I'm gonna trust her, then yes. If she fails, then she fails. I'm giving her the benefit of the doubt.
So trust yourself. That you're making the right decisions.
Yeah.
But when you don't trust yourself and you don't trust the people that are around you.
Yes.
So do you trust yourself?
Yes. I trust myself 100%.
Okay. So you trust that you made the right decision to give her the opportunity to clean the space for you?
Yes. I have to. Because if I don't, I tell it to her face. I don't trust her. But I did tell her. So.
So really quick, what does your future look like since you're always in that space?
My future is gonna be there, but I won't be able to enjoy it until after I finish. That's sad. After I finish my candidacy. A mayor can sit down and do the things that they want to do and then like chill out and like, no. The second I'm mayor, I'm going right to the races. From sun up to sundown, I'm going to fix my town. And 4 years straight, no one's going to say that I was just sitting and doing nothing. I want to put everything into the town when I'm done. And if people saw that I did with good intentions, I can look back sitting on my porch and say, I did something. I tried to do something and I wanted to work. That's the future I have right now.
That's beautiful. That's like a beautiful goal that you're working towards.
But I burned myself out real quick. So that's why I need times of reflection and disappearing. Because I can't just disappear for a month. And because I got my family, I got my kid. That's it. That's the only thing I gotta worry about is my family and my kid. Like, I have my house.
You have to really worry about this.
Yourself. No, I know. I know. And I know that if I don't fix myself, as you said, I can't help others. Not fix others, help others. And, that's why I'm doing this, because I want to learn different methods to just not. Everyone's telling me, like, you're just 1,000 miles a minute, you're not stopping. And it's great for you, for your enterprise and everything, but you're not being in the moment.
Yeah. And your PowerPoint is this. You're always using your voice to communicate your passion, your truth with people. And one really good technique that you can use is called mana.
Yeah.
And it's part of the yoga practice where you're sitting in silence. You can start with 30 minutes a day, disconnecting from your phone, disconnecting from everything, and just being in silence intentionally.
Yeah.
So that's a good start where you can just practice being without your voice, being without technology, being with you, and really tuning into Alex. What does Alex mean?
That's true. I do have at least 10 minutes of quiet time when I wake up. I don't touch my phone, I just sit outside and have a cigarette and listen to the birds and watch the wind blow.
Instead of being with the cigarette, can you be with the breath?
Yeah, you do that. I can do that if someone can do it at all, but, but I can't do that.
Just being with you without anything exterior that's taken away from your presence.
Yeah, I want to do that. Well, I'm sorry to do that. I go to the beach like every other day and sit down with my feet on the earth and just really like just listen to the waves. There's always a sound. There's no way to stop. Yeah.
It's just a flow of motion.
It's a wonderful thing. That's the best thing ever. It's better than TV because it's always on and it's always something new. Never the same sound twice. So you just be in the moment.
I like being in TV.
I do. It's nice.
No, that is.
Well, TV made from India?
No. Indian TV. Oh. Inspired.
Oh, no.
The best form of TV.
Oh, okay. I guess for me, it's river. That I can literally look at a river and I see little fishes.
It's
like,
water.
Yeah, that water.
Is water your element?
No, actually, it's fire. It's fire, but I do enjoy water.
Maybe you need the water to put the fire out.
True. I like nature. I'm always like nature. I love turtles, so it's turtles. And I do like fire, but not like obsession. Obsession, I'm very interested. Fire is cool. It can clean wounds, it can burn diseases off, but it can also destroy. Like, that's also power that you need to remember. A pencil can be a powerful tool for writing or a powerful weapon for her. You just gotta know what's the intention behind both those things. That's what I want to do. Yeah. It's like fire.
I have a lot of fire in my chart also. A lot of air. I'm always in the ether.
Yeah.
So earth and fire grounds me.
Yes. I guess fire and water grounds me.
So, full throttle, queen of the forest.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I picked it. My finger touched it. That's why I picked. Ooh. Yes. hit that like button.
Thanks for watching. Thanks for proceeding the magic that we're getting today.
And please remember, link down below to all our socials. If you live here in town, come by.
Yeah, I'll give you some information on where you can find me later. Are we live?
Yes. No, we're not live. We're not live. We're just recording. We're just recording. I cannot do a live right now. That's just too much. I'd rather do it like that, and if I'm thinking, I won't possibly even edit it. I just put it like one big long session. So just people can see everything.
And thank you for being on that.
Of course.
And showing up for yourself.
Of course, you told me I could show up myself.
Yeah, but do you understand what I'm saying?
Yes.
You can show up in the surface way, but actually like coming to do the work, receive the knowledge, and once you apply it, is another thing.
I don't trust to do work. I've known you for 10 years. You've never faulted anybody. You've never